In 1995, two Stanford computer science graduates, Paige and Brin, collaborated in a research project to do web backlink analysis. The project resulted in a company that changed the internet, Google. Welcome to our animated history channel. This show presents a brief history of Google. The name Google is a play on words of Google, which is a mathematical term for the number one followed by 100 zeros. It is said that this reflects the founder's mission to organize the infinite amount of information on the internet. In 1995, Paige and Brin met at Stanford University while they were graduate students in computer science. Later, the pair began co-writing a program for a search engine dubbed Backrub. It is named after its ability to do a backlink analysis. The outcome is summarized in a widely popular research paper titled The Anatomy of a Large-Scale Hypertextual Web Search Engine. The search engine was unique in that it used a technology they developed called PageRank. The PageRank determined a website's relevance by taking into account the number of pages along with the importance of the pages that linked back to the original site. At that time, search engines such as Yahoo ranked results based on how often a search term appeared on a web page. Fueled by the rave reviews that Backrub received, Paige and Brin began working on developing Google. It was very much a shoestring project at that time. Operating out of their dorm rooms, the pair built a server network using cheap, used, and borrowed personal computers. They even maxed their credit cards, buying terabytes of disks at discount prices. The first version of Google was released in 1996 on the Stanford website. Originally, the search engine used Stanford's website with the domain google.stanford.edu. The domain google.com was registered a year later. After more development, the Google search engine eventually turned into a hot commodity. Sun Microsystems co-founder Andy Bechtolsheim was so impressed that after a quick demo of Google, he told the pair, "Instead of discussing all the details, why don't I just write you a check?" Bechtolsheim's check was for $100,000 and was made out to Google Incorporated, despite the fact that Google as a legal entity did not exist yet. The next step didn't take long. However, Paige and Brin incorporated on September 4th, 1998. The check also enabled them to raise $900,000 more for their initial round of funding. Other angel investors included Amazon founder Jeff Bezos. With sufficient funds, Google opened its first office in Menlo Park, California, in their friend Susan Wojcicki's garage. Wojcicki eventually became an executive at Google and is now the CEO at YouTube. On June 7, 1999, a round of equity funding totaling $25 million was announced, the major investors being rival venture capital firms Kleiner Perkins, Caulfield & Byers, and Sequoia Capital. While Google still needed more funding for their further expansion, Brin and Paige were hesitant to take the company public, despite their financial issues. The Google search engine attracted a loyal following among the growing number of internet users, who liked its simple design. In 2000, Google began selling advertisements associated with search keywords. Keywords were sold based on a combination of price bid and click-throughs, with bidding starting at 5 cents per click. Following the investment, Sequoia encouraged Brin and Paige to hire a CEO. Brin and Paige ultimately acquiesced and hired Eric Schmidt as Google's first CEO in March 2001. In October 2003, while discussing a possible initial public offering of shares, IPO, Microsoft approached the company about a possible partnership or merger. The deal never materialized. 4 months later, Google announced an IPO to raise as much as $4 billion. After quickly outgrowing other sites, the company leased a complex of buildings in Mountain View at 1600 Amphitheater Parkway. The company has remained at this location ever since, and the complex has become known as the Googleplex. Google quietly acquired Android in 2005 for an undisclosed price, which has been estimated at $50 million. Buying Android was Google's best deal ever, said David Lawy, vice president of corporate development at the search giant. Android is a mobile operating system based on a modified version of the Linux kernel. It is designed primarily for touchscreen mobile devices such as smartphones and tablets. In addition, Google has further developed Android TV for televisions, Android Auto for cars, and Wear OS for wristwatches, each with a specialized user interface. During the period of rapid growth, the company introduced a variety of products, including Gmail, Google Docs, Google Drive, a web browser Chrome, a smart speaker Google Home, broadband Google F, self-driving cars, and numerous other ventures. It also acquired streaming video platform YouTube, smart home product Nest, and Blogger.com. Advertising revenue generated by search requests remains its biggest earnings driver, however. In 2015, Google underwent a restructuring of divisions and personnel under the conglomerate name Alphabet. Sergey Brin became president of the newly formed parent company, while Larry Page is the CEO. His position at Google was filled with the promotion of Sundar Pichai. In early 2016, Alphabet Inc. surpassed Apple to become the world's most valuable publicly traded company for some weeks. Google.com is the most powerful and popular search engine in the world, processing more than 40,000 search queries every second, which means 3.5 billion searches per day and typically 1.2 trillion searches per year. What do you know about Google and Alphabet? Tell us in the comments. Also, check out our other videos on history of other big corporations. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.